Australia is set to spend up to $2 billion acquiring high-tech rocket system launchers used on the battlefield in Ukraine. Federal politics reporter Eliza Edwards has the details this morning. Eliza, these are credited to helping turning the tide in Ukraine's war effort.
Absolutely, Charles. And now Australia is getting a slice of these extremely effective weapons. The Albanese government will spend up to $2 billion on new missile launches. It includes 20 land-based high-mobility artillery rocket systems from the United States that can be fired from a range of 300 kilometres. These are the same weapons donated by the US and used successfully, as you said, by Ukraine in its fight against Russia. Then there'll also be new capabilities for Australia on the water as well. The government signing a new deal to acquire naval strike missiles for our Navy fleet. These purchases, described by some in the government as the single most significant investment in the nation's strike capability in living memory, if not ever, it will help to get our defence force up to date and keep possible future adversaries at bay. Charles.
Eliza, thank you. Australia's Defence Force will still soon have access to the same long-range missile launchers Ukraine has praised for helping turn the tide in the fight against Russia. Federal politics reporter Eliza Edwards has the details. Eliza, these come with a hefty price tag.
They do, Charles. Up to $2 billion will be spent on this game changer for the Australian Defence Force that will soon be equipped with an unprecedented long-range strike capability. The federal government buying 20 US-made truck-mounted weapons that Ukraine has praised for their devastating effectiveness in the fight against Russia. These are high-mobility artillery rocket systems and they have a strike range of up to 300 kilometres. Another purchase is for the Australian Navy. Next year, our warships will be equipped with new naval strike missiles. The Defence Minister says we need this kind of capability in the current uncertain strategic environment. Charles.
Eliza, thank you.